Half done? Let me ask you questions then.
How much are you?
Why is so much noise? That I'll finish next week. Let me finish Albert Einstein. No problem. No. We are so excited about Ranga's marriage. So we want to be invited. Yes. I want to see what happens. We love getting invitations for our marriages, isn't it? So we want to go to Ranga's marriage also. But sadly, we are going to go to school with Albert Einstein. Let's go there. Okay? Yes, we're going to. So Albert Einstein at school, it is a chapter about snapshots. Chapter 4. Let me just give them an introduction here. It's about, Albert Einstein's experience at school. And we know about Albert Einstein as a great genius. Right? So what do you think about the people who are there, you know, as geniuses? Extraordinary intelligence? Yes? Way ahead of others, they would be in classroom also. What about the syllabus and things that you have to do in the class? So people who are there, right, naturally they are already very excited and curious about learning, that they would love to read and would love to learn more and more. Now when we read this chapter, it is also about the education system, right? The limitations of the education system. You had your ASL on NEP. Do you remember? Yes. So what were the changes that you expect to happen? When you talk about the examination system, that is the end assessment, right? What can we change about the education system? If you had to make a few changes, you got the chance, okay, for one day. Please suggest the changes. Let's make those changes. Yes, Mansi, what changes would you like to bring about? Yes? They're not implemented. Okay, right. So you know about the changes. Can you tell me about those changes? What? Yes, Navya? Okay. Vocational education we're talking about. Yes. Right. What else? Flexibility of subjects. Right. Yeah. Learning from your experiences. You are taught a concept and yeah, you are made to work on that. Right. Okay. So online examinations, just forget that. Your digital learning will continue, but not necessarily. Yeah, your assessment might not be there. Okay. What about the exams? Is there anything you'd like to change about the exams? Yes. Multiple choice questions are best. Online exams are best. That was a very, you know, like different situation. That is when we talk about online exams here. Right, but what about it? Yeah, Harsimran is there saying, yeah, absolutely, online exams should be there. What else do you want to change about it? What about learning in the classroom? I'm not talking about holidays, I'm not talking about timetable. I am talking about studying in the school. When you come to school and when you leave school after so many years, what is it that you want to be? What kind of a person would you like to leave the school as? Yes, anyone? Megha? Yes? Yes, Megha? So when you leave the school, you want to be? That's how you did Ranga's marriage. So when you leave the school, do you want to be someone who has excelled in studies because you crammed a lot? Or is it you want to be someone who did well in school because of the learning experiences? A option or B option? This is the language we understand nowadays. A, B, both? No, this is not there. I have not given both. I've not given none. I've given A or B. Which one? Obviously, you want to be a person who is there, not, you know, like thinking that my mark sheet is showing my knowledge or my capability. I am beyond my mark. So this is one criteria that needs to be changed, right? And of course, that your marks should not define your knowledge. Yeah, and your future also. Now, but yes, these things definitely change here. They should change. They are going to change. And yes, right, apart from learning, we should know how to apply that knowledge. Yes, we need to learn things which will make us confident and successful in life. Like, yeah, we're talking about the digital world here. It could be other skills also. So not everyone is there, you know, like, okay, happy doing that. But that is something which I think everybody should know. Apart from that, other vocational skills it could be. Hands-on experience, right? Learning things by doing yourself. Right? That will make you equipped to deal or be independent in life. Right? So what about subjects here? Right, supposing if you have not learned the dates in history, do you think you should be failed in that subject? Yes. So if you don't know the dates, you'll fail? You will fail because the pattern of the paper is such that you have to learn the dates. What? So you don't want to learn the dates. Oh, but you get marks because you're able to write down the dates correctly. Okay, because at the end of the day, marks matter. Is it? Right. So when we talk about Albert Einstein, you will believe me when I tell you that he also had a problem. According to him, going to school does not mean, you know, learning all so much of information. Cramming your textbooks and at the end of the day, writing down the answers. Do you call that learning? No, we cannot call that learning. Learning has to be something very engaging, something which makes you confident, something which gives you a skill, something that gives you an experience, right? And on account of that experience or on account of that learning, you can apply it also, right? So it is not, okay, just tell me the sequence of the periodic table. Oh, you know it, very good. You've passed in chemistry, right? Okay, tell me the dates here, important dates, when this revolution took place, when that. You know all the dates. Oh my God, you're very good at history. Is this the kind of assessment that should be done? No, we don't want that kind of assessment. So Albert Einstein, he had a big problem with his teachers because he was not happy in school. He did not want to learn the dates. But the teacher thought that, yes, if someone says that I don't want to learn the dates and I can't learn the dates. Is it wrong to speak like that in class? Yes. Okay. We're talking about that time. And now it's perfectly acceptable. Times have changed. So if you talk to your parents today, you talk to them about their schooling system. If you are there with your grandparents, talk to them. Remember Portrait of a Lady, how grandmother used to take Khushwant Singh to school and he would learn his lessons, and then she would, you know, like write, read the scriptures, and how she was not happy with the English medium or even the subjects taught and music and things like that, right? Because she did not give much importance to them, right? So teachers have changed, subjects have changed, the school system has also changed. We need to focus not only on academics, but on activities as well. We want a child, when the child comes out of school, child should feel confident. I have skills also. I have knowledge also. I am confident enough to face the world. Okay. Now let us start with the chapter here, and let's find out what do you think is the problem of Albert Einstein. Which page are you doing? So what about Albert Einstein? He did not like to learn dates. He felt that instead of learning dates, I would like to learn why this battle took place. What was the result of that battle? Did it have the desired result, right? If it was defeated or victorious, did it change the course of history, right? So he's saying, what is there in learning when this took place? So he was not happy with that. And the teachers, they were not happy because Albert Einstein used to ask a lot of questions. They felt because he is asking questions, what is going to happen? Other students are also going to behave like him. And he's creating a disturbance in the class. Others will also get disturbed, right? And Albert Einstein, he was living away from his parents, right? And his parents, they could not afford to, you know, like make him stay where the other boys were staying. So he was living in a very humble lodging, a very humble place, right? So it was not a very well developed area, and there was a lot of violence over there, right? And the house where he lived in, or the room that he had, the landlady, she was also quite noisy, quite violent. Her husband would come drunk in the weekends and he would also beat her. So in such a kind of an atmosphere, he was not very happy. So Albert Einstein was not happy in school. He was not happy at home. Right? Nowadays, we talk a lot about depression and a nervous breakdown and things like that. When do you think you reach a such a point, you think, oh my God, I cannot bear this any longer? When? When you're constantly happy or when you are unhappy? You're happy and suddenly the breakdown happens? No, what else? How can you say that? You know, it is there. It is not something to be taken so lightly also. When you talk about being depressed and being unhappy, when you are in a constant state of unhappiness, things which gave you happiness, which gave you pleasure, do not give, you know, excitement. You don't feel like talking to others, right? And it is there. You are there constantly struggling yourself to get out of that situation. So there are times when you really need to talk. Nowadays, we really address that. We talk about that more than our physical health. What matters more is our mental health, right? Because at the end of the day, yes, you sit straight, please. Sit straight. All these three boys in a row. We need to talk about our mind also. What are the thoughts that go in our mind? We have a lot of confusion, maybe understanding ourselves, understanding the situation we are in, right? And sometimes, yes, you do notice your friend who was once so lively and so active has started behaving strangely. So we need to really talk about these matters. Now when, yes, Navya? He was expressing his thoughts. He was asking questions, but was the teacher able to understand him? No. And what did the teacher think that he was asking questions? What is it, an act of disobedience, right? So he was not happy in the school that again, I'll go to school tomorrow. The teacher is again not going to listen to me. The same situation is going to happen, right? He would come back home. What was there at home? What was the environment? Yes, boys, silence. What was the environment at home? Unhappy. So he was there in that constant state of unhappiness. He wanted to study more. He wanted to learn more. But the teachers have told him that, see, I have this much syllabus. I can't tell you to read more. Right? Fine. And yes, so some teachers did tell him that, yeah, you carry on. Because they understood that this child has that thirst for knowledge. Right? So yes, he wanted to read more about science. He wanted to read more about, you know, other subjects. But because of limitations, he could not. And because of the limitations of the education system also. Because are we equipped to deal with children who are in way intelligent than others? No. Are we equipped to deal with children who are as not fast as learning as others? No. So extremes, we don't know how to handle, isn't it? So whether it's a slow learner, whether it's a child prodigy or a genius, right? And when you talk about Albert Einstein, when you talk about his intelligence, we know that he was, his IQ, remarkable. And you've read about in class 9th also chapter about Albert Einstein or not? Yes, a beautiful mind, right? Okay, so Albert Einstein, he was not happy. He wanted to talk. There was no one that he could talk to. Did he have many friends? No. He had one friend that we are going to talk about. Who was that? That was Urey. Okay? Yes. They are not all civilized. Urey replied. Look at your books, please. Did you not hear that one of them was killed last week in a duel? And what happens to the one who killed him? Nothing, of course. He is even proud of it. His only worry is that the authorities have told him not to fight any more duels. What's a duel? Two parties involved, two people there, right? The fight. Yeah, so street fight. Okay. He's upset about this because he hasn't a single scar on his face to wear for the rest of his life as a badge of honor. What does this sign mean? Because, yeah, he did not get any scar, you know, like while fighting, he did not receive any bruises and injuries, which he can proudly show. Right? And see, I was involved in a street fight and I got the scar from there. Right? So that means these boys are not afraid of hurting and killing others. This is the kind of environment. Is that kind of an environment good for learning? It's bad. It's violent. It's not. Exclaimed Albert. And these are the students. Well, you'll be a student one day. When you leave your school, you go for higher studies. I doubt it, said Albert glumly. I don't think I'll ever pass the exams for the school diploma. Albert thinks he's never going to pass the exams. So is there something wrong with the examination system? That's why he's saying? Yes. What did he find wrong about the examination system? Learning, cramming, and writing down everything that you have without understanding, right? So he did not like that. He told his cousin Elsa the same next time she came to Munich. Normally, she lived in Berlin where her father had a business. So she's come to Munich, otherwise she lived in Berlin. Which place are we talking about? Which country are we talking about? Where is Munich? Where is Berlin? Foreign country. Berlin is a foreign country. Where is this foreign country? Berlin? Have you heard of Germany? Okay. I'm sure you could learn enough to pass the exams, Albert, if you try, she said. I know lots of boys who are much more stupid than you are, who get through. Get through means pass. They say you don't have to know anything. You don't have to understand what you're taught. Just be able to repeat it in the exam. Has she summarized the whole idea of the exam? Yes. This is advice. She says, don't understand, just cram it and then go and write it. You'll pass. And for a person who is so curious, is it easy to cram things? No. That's the whole trouble, said Albert. I am no good at learning things by heart. So I can't memorize things. I can't cram things. You don't need to be good at it. Anyone can learn like a parrot. When you were kids in nursery school, in kindergarten, how you used to recite your rhymes? Like a parrot, without thinking or understanding. You would listen, okay, these are the lines, and any time of the day and night. So now, and you would start off, okay. Isn't it? Right? So he says, anyone can learn like a parrot. You just don't try. And yet, I always see you with the book. So why are you roaming around with the book if you're not learning it? Under your arm, what is the one you're reading? A book on geology. Geology? Rocks and things? Do you learn that? What is geology? Rocks and things? Yes, study of rocks, the earth, right? The composition. No. Do you learn that? No. We have hardly any science at school. So we don't have much of a science. So it's in social sciences also. In your geography also, you learn about that. Then why are you studying it? Because I like it. Isn't that a good enough reason? But my school system says, I have to do the subjects which are there. I cannot do the subjects that I like. These are the subjects. This is what you study, right? Okay, so if I want to study economics, I'm interested in biology. Why don't I have the freedom to do that? I should, right? My education system should be so flexible, but it is not. So these are the subjects that you have to study. That's it. End of it. You're right, of course, Albert, but it won't help with your diploma. See, once again, you're reading these books, and if you want to learn something, should learning be just for the sake of learning? It can be. Or learning has to be for exams always. Learning has to be exams based? No. Learning could be something you're interested in. It's not your subject, but you want to read about history. You want to read about politics. You want to read about finance. You want to read about, creative writing or anything. It's your choice. Yes? Yeah, which can, because you have interest and you feel I might pursue it later on, might use it later on, isn't it? Apart from books on science, his only comfort was music. Whose comfort? Einstein's comfort was music. And he played his violin regularly until his landlady asked him to stop. So he would play the violin. We've all read about that, Einstein. He would love to play the violin. That wailing gets on my nerves. Which wailing? What is a wailing sound? Crying sound, like someone is there. Wailing, crying. So what did the lady think of the violin? What did she think about his efforts? Were they good enough? No. She thought it's a crying sound. Someone is very sad. Yes, girls, what? So that wailing gets on my nerves. She said, there's enough noise in this house with all the kids howling. Already there's a lot of noise. The kids keep on howling the whole day. Why are you adding to the noise? You're making a violin sound and it is creating more noise. Albert was tempted to point out that most of the time it was she who made them howl. But he decided it was better to say nothing. How did she make them howl? By beating them, making them cry. So she say, wanted to say, you're the one who makes them make so much of noise. Okay? Not us. And then what will you do? Yuri asked. Wait. Albert was tempted, but he decided to say nothing. I must get away from here. He told Yuri after 6 months alone in Munich. Who's Yuri? Yuri? His only friend. Yes, last boy over there. Where's your book? Can you sit straight? He told Yuri after 6 months alone in Munich, it is absurd that I should go on like this. In the end, it will turn out that I have been wasting my father's money and everyone's time. It will be better for law if I stop now. I'm saying it's better I stop because I don't think so I'll pass the exams. So it's better I make the right choice. I'm not happy here. I can't study here. And what I want to study, they are not allowing me to. So he decided to leave instead of wasting his father's money. And then what will he do? Yuri asked, I don't know. If I go to Milan, I'm afraid my father will send me back. Now, where is Milan? Italy. Okay. So if I go to Milan, I'm afraid my father will send me back. He wants to go there for his higher studies. Unless his eyes gleamed with a sudden idea. Yuri, do you know any friendly doctors? I know a lot of medical students and some of them are friendly, said Yuri. Doctor, no, I never had enough money to go to one. Why? Suppose, said Albert, that I had a nervous breakdown. Suppose a doctor would say it's bad for me to go to school and I need to get right away from it. So he's saying if a doctor gives me the certificate that I am not fit enough to attend school, I have to go away. It will serve my purpose. Who's that boy there? Get up. Ramni, get up. Come over here. What is our attitude towards people who have mental issues? We stay away from them. Why? Yes? We pity them. How do we come to know that this person has a mental issue? What mental issues am I talking about? Someone who's not very happy, someone who's not comfortable, right? Okay, yes. You tease. Do we tell people that I have a mental issue? No, we don't. Why don't we talk about it? That's it. Because we take a person who is there, wants to talk about his mind, wants to talk about his difficult situation, we immediately classify that person. Is that the case? No. Sometimes we need to talk for counseling, right? We might be taking the wrong decision. We might be having a wrong view of things. So it is very, very important that we need to talk. We need to discuss this problem. And as it is, you know, when you do talk, when you discuss your issues there, we are able to sort out so many things. Do you think people with who are there having some kind of a mental issues, they're always sad and unhappy? No, not necessarily. No, listening to sad songs, oh my God, such stereotypes we have, isn't it? Sitting alone, right in the corner of the classroom or anywhere. No, we have a very wrong notion. Sometimes the happiest people can also be the saddest ones. Yeah, have breakdowns. Right? So yes, it is there. Once again, what is happiness? What makes us happy? Do you think, is it money? Is it good food? Is it a comfortable home? Or is it peace of mind? Everything? Actually, it is peace of mind. When you are able to get a good night's sleep, when you are very happy with yourself, you are at peace with yourself, you're happy with your environment, with your surroundings, that is when you are in a very happy mental space. You enjoy what you're doing. You are happy with your friends. You're happy with your life. What more can I ask for? Right? But sometimes there might be incidents, there might be things which make us very uncomfortable. Then is the time when we need to talk about it. And we notice also, like, supposing, yeah, right, if tomorrow her Simar decides to behave in the class, I'll immediately wonder what is wrong with him. Why is he so disciplined and why is he so obedient? What's the reason? Although it might be, yeah, that today he's decided to be a good boy, which is a far far distant the thought, isn't it? Right? So Tishnu decides, oh my God, I won't keep on roaming around in the classes here. I wonder what happened. Your friend is absent today. Why is he sitting in the class? Isn't it? Right? So we do notice a change in the person's behavior. But if that change is constant, then it is something really to be worried about. Right? What? Maybe I'm giving you a hint. So maybe I'm telling you. Right, they're weak in understanding things.